do. Okay, this piece is called Comb. This is Duet for Piano. And this is the primary audience of the pianist. I didn't really have a plan going into it. I think that was a big part of it, even though I read it before. But I think most of the time I was thinking over not what I wanted to, well, yeah, what I wanted to do, but a lot of it was what Sam, what I was thinking, what Sam had in mind, which I think is quite interesting because even though the piece is like pretty much completely open to interpretation, even in terms of structure as well, it seemed like I was still thinking, what's he trying to get from it rather than what I was trying to perform myself. And then when I was kind of going through it, and it did feel like kind of random, like harmonic, like chordal things. And then I was kind of like criticizing that as I was playing at the same time. But yeah, it was enjoyable to play. I think the element of choice like is quite a big thing. And it's probably quite a good way to kind of have improvised, like improvisation, but structured improvisation in a way, because it makes it kind of more like you've got a little bit of a plan to go with as you're doing it. But yeah, so just like things in your head that you come up with and then you do it on the spot. I guess you just do something. I think that's quite good about this, is that you just play something and then you have to work from that. So you just kind of end up just doing what feels right the next part. So you're not even like, if you're even like improvising, you're with like, even just yourself, you've also got like a kind of chordal structure. But here, since you're completely like absent of that, you've just got to keep pushing forward. So you're always thinking about the next thing rather than, oh, I've got to like keep it going for the next like four bars kind of thing. So that was interesting as well. This piece is called Problematic Authorship. So I chose to, I actually looked at it by looking at pieces that I myself like haven't composed, and then just playing with that, really in a mix of stuff that I've done myself, just on the spot, like things that just came to me from playing those things. And then at the end I had that kind of like 1-6-5-4 chord progression, which is just like so common among like pop music, so I thought it'd be quite funny to add in because it's everywhere all the time. So yeah. It was different to the other one. I think it had like less, well, obviously it had less structure, so it just kind of has like one, I mean, it's got, you know, let rip there kind of thing. I feel like maybe I didn't go as crazy as like I should have on reflection, but I was trying to like encapsulate that kind of thing, that even though it's like me who's doing this, there's like so many other elements as well, like that aren't from me in this, as a beast.
Like responding to the title.
Yeah, responding. Yeah. Uh-huh.